A great way to add character to your models is to add weathering and battle damage to them. And in this video, I'm going to show you a couple of techniques for how to do this. And this will be adding scratches, how to chip armor, how to add grime, and also how to add mud to your miniatures. Now, doing this is actually really fun, so let's get started. Weathering and battle damage is something that I normally leave to the very end of painting a model. So I've got a fully painted Bulgrin here, and he's been painted in the colour scheme of the Tempestor Scions. Now we do have some videos on painting a Tempestor Scion, so if you've not seen those already, I recommend you go and check them out. And well, the effect I'm going to do on him is quite deep scratches, so this is going to be great for things like claw marks and stuff like that. And to do it, I need two colours. Now the first one I need to pick is a dark colour, so I've gone for Dryad Bark, and that's because I originally shaded his armour with a brown. Now, for a highlight for this effect, I've gone for Fenrisian Grey, and that's because I originally highlighted the armour with Fenrisian Grey. And you see, picking these two colours, I'm going to keep the effect consistent with the rest of the colour scheme. And we'll be starting with the Dryad Bark, so as always, give the paint a good shake, and the brush you need for this is a fine detail brush. And what you need to do, first of all, is just gather some of your paint and pop it onto your palette. And you will need to thin it down a little bit, and it's very, very important that you get a fine tip on your brush. So a trick I like to do is to drag my brush along and twist it like this, just to bring and focus all those bristles together like that. So you see I've got a nice fine tip on the brush there. And what you're looking to do is, as neatly as you can, paint a thin straight line on his armor just like this. So just something like that is ideal. So now that the Dryad Bark's dry, we're ready to highlight it. So with Fenrisian Grey, I just need to prepare the brush in exactly the same way. So as before, thinning it down with a little bit of water and then making sure I've got a really fine tip on my brush, like that. Now what I need to do is, well, the light will be falling downwards on the model, so I need to highlight underneath the scratch. So as neatly as possible, what you do is just paint a thin line running along the previous line, like that. There you go, you see it's made the illusion that I've got a deep scratch in his armour. Now I could add a few more like this and then it will look like a Tyranid's been attacking him, but I've also seen some people doing like really elaborate things with this, so creating chaos runes and stuff etched into the armour. So go and have a go with it and see what you can create. Now I'm going to show you how to add a chipping effect to your models, and I'm going to be using my Hydra for an example for this. And what you need to do first is find yourself a piece of sponge. And I've got here a spare piece out of one of my figure cases, and this is ideal because the holes on it are really small. So what you do is just bunch it up like that and grab a hold of a pot of Skaven Blight Dinge and just dip the sponge in it like that, and then start dabbing it onto your palette. Now this is almost like doing a dry brush, I'm just getting rid of excess paint, and I'm also, using this, able to judge how much is in the sponge. So it's about good, like that. And what you do is just grab your model and start very lightly dabbing this onto the armor like that. And you'll see you get a really cool and completely random pattern appearing on it, and it looks, well, it looks like the primer underneath the paint. Now it's much harder to remove this effect than it is to add it, so be gentle with it and take your time and just add as much as you want until you're happy with it. Now I've finished the Skaven Blight Dinge, you can see the kind of effect it's having. It's like the primer is starting to show through the paint. And what we need to do now is just finish it off. So for this, I'm going to be using Lead Belcher, and well, the technique is the same really. I've got the same sponge and I've cleaned it with water and made sure that it's dried first before doing this. And just like before, it's going to pick up some of the paint and start putting it on the palette like this. And this time, we're going to be applying less paint, so you don't need very much on the sponge. And what you do, look on your model to see the areas where you sponged before and just start very lightly adding some silver to it. Now you really don't need very much, you need to keep the effect subtle, but you can see that silver's just starting to glint through there, like it's the bare metal beneath. So I'm just going to work around the model now doing this, and well, you can see this effect works really, really well on all sorts of tanks, and I've even seen people doing it on Space Marines too. But remember, most important thing about this is that, well, do it in moderation. You can always add more if you want to. So there you go, you can see the kind of effect that this has had on the model. It looks like it's been out in the field for quite some time now. As you've seen, this effect's really easy to achieve, but if you're going to do it on your models, I recommend you keep it consistent across all the tanks in your army. A really great way to have a well-used and weather-worn appearance on your vehicles is to add a grimy texture to it. And there's a paint designed to do this called typhus corrosion, which looks like a shade, but well, it actually isn't, because it's got a very fine gritty texture to it. Now I've got some here and I'm going to apply some to my Hydra. Now the brush I'm using is a detail brush, and well, using this stuff is very easy. Just load your brush up with some of it. And what you do is start painting it into recessed areas in the vehicle, like along here, for example. So just paint some in there. You can see the kind of dirty, grimy texture it gives to the model. Now, another great place to apply this stuff is on things like bolts and rivets. And what you do is just paint a bit of it around them like that, and then have a small amount just running down from it like that. You see, and it gives the appearance of collected grime and, well, rainwater and things running down from the bolt. So you can see the kind of effect it has on your model, but I do recommend as you're adding it, you do it in moderation, because you can always add more later on if you want to. It's much harder to take this off than it is to put it on. So I'm just going to add some more now, but well, you can see the sort of effect it gives your model. Really adds loads of character to it. So add as much until you're happy. The last thing I'm going to show you is how to add the effect of caked up mud on the tracks of your vehicles. And for doing this, you're going to need a pot of Stirling mud. And the brush I'm using is a medium dry brush. And well, what you do is get some of it loaded on your brush like this, and then get your vehicle and just start roughly stippling it onto the tracks down here like this. So you see all this mud is caking up around the side here, and I can get a really good texture on it. So add plenty like this, so you're seeing that texture start to appear like that. Be really rough with it. And then of course we need to start going up the track links themselves as well like this. So I'm going to keep applying this now on all four of these track units, and then I'm going to give it about half an hour to dry. Now once you've applied as much as you want and you've let it dry, we can move on to the next step, which is to use Tyrant Skull. And this is a dry paint, and I'll be using a medium dry brush for applying this. It's actually the same brush I was using before, but I've made sure it's completely dry before moving on to this stage. And it's important you do that, because if you don't, it can leave a bit of a streaky mark on your model. So all you do is load your brush up with a bit of this, and then you start pushing it into some tissue like this. And this is going to work that paint in amongst the bristles and get rid of any excess paint that we don't need, because you really don't need very much on your brush here. In fact, having the brush like that is perfect. And what you do is get your model and very lightly start drawing this back and forth over that texture that you've applied. And what this does is, well, it highlights the mud. You can see it's starting to pick out the texture of it. And this means that now you'll see clearly all that texture from a distance. So you really don't need very much on this because, well, I want that mud to stay dark so it looks wet. But, well, you can see the kind of effect it's having. It's as easy as that. So there you go. That's how you do this effect. It looks great and, well, very easy. So there you go. That's four great techniques for applying weathering and battle damage to your models. Now, as you've seen, they're actually really easy to do and really satisfying as well. So it's easy to get carried away and apply too much. So I recommend that you apply them in moderation, because you can always add more later if you want to. Also, these techniques are best used as the last part of painting a model, so that's even after you've applied all the transfers. But, well, I hope you guys have enjoyed this video and I hope you found it useful, so go and have a go and get creative.